good day to you, partner. I'm Gee, and I can already tell that I'll be your best friend in this forsaken camp.
Oh, welcome to... I woke up in the morning, baby, when I felt around for my suit.
Hey guys, it's Sweet Solo, aka the Skeleton King, and I wanted to make this video to show how I play in PUGs. The way I play in PUGs is the most fun I have in Diablo 2 right now as a Summonmancer. For a long time, it was playing solo. The reason I had more fun playing solo than in a group is basically the functionality of your minions in group play is almost zero. There are so many times they accomplish absolutely nothing, regardless of whether on paper they actually do pretty good damage. They're going to be nerfing revives. I would say revives are responsible for the lion's share of your DPS, whether you're skeletons or golems. And if they don't seriously buff skeletons, there will be no reason to play a Summonmancer. It's actually, I hope they understand this. I think maybe their fear is they don't want people to be powerful who do absolutely nothing besides stand behind their minions. And that's another reason I wanted to show this video, is I don't think that's the way I play. And so I don't care if some guy benefits by summons being a, let's say top 10. Let's say they're one of the top 10 best damage dealers. Let's just say that, just, you know what, there's the Dragon Din, and there's the Zahn, and there's the Lightning Zahn, and there's the, you know, the Jab Zahn, which is actually insane damage, you just don't see them very often. You see them more these days, but yeah. So let's say I was 10th best. You know, where if I was in a group, I could carry them damage-wise. Who cares? Who cares if some retard gets the benefit from that? Never punish players because a skill or a class has a, what's the word for it? A lame style of play. For instance, just because some people don't like the way Puff plays in Melee, it doesn't mean Puff is the best character. And it also doesn't mean that Puff should be nerfed because people don't like to enjoy that playstyle. You never want to nerf or buff classes based on some sort of perspective bias of fun. So back to this. The reason why I can't do good damage, even though on paper my damage actually is pretty good. Again, it doesn't compete with the best damage dealers in this game. There's no way you could compete with a Dragon Din or a Aura Din or even a Dreama Din. They do basically 100k per charge, and what that means is they one-tap the whole screen. But I almost do 100k DPS. It's just, you would never tell. For one, my splash radius is smaller, and two, look at this Uduar. He's attacking this guy, and then he runs off. That's the reason why you could buff summons by 2 times, and I still wouldn't be one of the top 10 best classes. What that has to do with is it has to do with the fact that this game runs at 25 frames per second. So every 25 frames, the game is going to calculate new animations or new pathing for their AI. If my blundergores miss a computation cycle, or for whatever reason they compute poorly, they do zero DPS for almost a whole second. And look at, so the guy just runs like past 5 enemies to attack one. So what that means is probably he was in, you know, Wander AI or whatever it is, or skeletons have a Wander AI. I'm not the guy to really talk to about this. And then, you know, he got to a new computation cycle and then picked an enemy to aggro and then hit. Even if they never did that, which I don't think you could fix that part. Let's just say there's no way you could make the AI better, because there probably isn't, I don't know, maybe there's a generally better AI and you could give them all the good one. There's another thing they do to enemy minions or summons is that they're frame locked every 15 frames. So they'll attack and then they're frame locked. So all of those things can combine into one huge issue. This is the closest I came to dying all night. And that was because I had no idea why those death molars were attacking me. So it was like, it blew my mind. So besides the fact that you can't do reliable damage, then what am I trying to accomplish here? By the way, I actually do pretty good single target DPS. No, I don't compete with a Zealer anymore. I think if a Zealer doesn't have, you know, pretty good gear, let's say 15 high runes, I think I actually out DPS them single target only. And that's because revives, mainly. And skeletons are actually pretty good single target. Like I said, in a group, I can easily hit, you know, 40, 50k plus. Like, if there's an Enchantress, I got a bunch of buffs. For instance, if I get a plus 2 or a plus 3 battle orders and a skill shrine, my skeletons do 40k DPS without considering, you know, a pride or a might or a better fanaticism. Just me buffing them. So I can actually do pretty good single target DPS. But functional group DPS is impossible. The reason why I can do functional single-target DPS is because I can tele-stomp. And so even if they don't lock on the first one, I can re-tele-stomp. Or even if one enemy doesn't lock, at least most of my damage is there. When there's a group, the chance that my summons just run around accomplishing nothing is very high. So even if I could do top 10 DPS, I never will, because the chance my minions are doing nothing while they have the opportunity to deal damage exists. So for instance, I tele-stomp to a group, my minions don't do anything, and then the group kills them anyways. Even when they nerf Dragondens and they nerf Zons, if you have a group of 7 people doing consistent damage, they're always going to accomplish more functionally than you will. And so the chance that you get to do good damage in a group is very low. So that's why I came up with this gameplay. I don't want to just sit behind and tank. And for one, you don't really end up tanking anyways, unless you're in a pretty bad group. Because the group is so fast, your summons don't really stick to the enemies. So what I do is I tele-stomp, curse, tele-stomp, curse, tele-stomp, curse. And I'm not necessarily even trying to tele-stomp. What I'm trying to do is occupy aggro to apply curses. And then once the group gets there, I'm no longer needed. So then what I do is I either tele-stomp to ranged enemies, or I just tele-stomp behind that group, and then start cursing the next group. Because the only way a Dragonden dies is if there's some sort of bad luck, like their in-charge animation, it doesn't hit, and they get hit first, and then, you know, they get, like, frame-locked. Or they don't cause that frame recovery, and they do attack. And that's how they die, because they're very squishy. The reason why you don't see them die very much is because they deal so much damage, they almost never get hit by enemies. So what I want to do is just put amp damage, weaken. By the way, I think Decrepify is technically better for the rest of the group, because all they need to do is put enemies on frame recovery. But weaken is safer for me, because I don't get to put enemies into reliable frame recovery. So the chance they attack me is very high. Just lowering their attack speed isn't going to do too much, because the chance they attack me before I get to move away and I really get the benefit from that Decrepify exists. But the weaken, it noticeably, I can take 3 more attacks. And that to me is worth a lot. So again, see? Curses, move. Curses, move. Curses, move. Curses, move. And again, what you're always going to want to do is after tele-stomping, move right away. If you don't move right away, for one, you can be targeted. And two, your revives don't attack. And it's not really that you're trying to deal damage, but you can, and you want to, because, you know, you get to kill some. Oh, I killed a skeleton! Hey, look at that! Did you see that damage? That was actually pretty good. You know what probably happened? Is they all attacked for whatever reason. S got lucky, and they were all, you know, boom. Again, it was a great pack for me. I tele-stomped to the right, moved back, put curses, tele-stomped behind, put curses, moved. That was a really good one. And so that way is I can make the enemies disappear when the groups get there. And for me, it's really fun because I'm always doing something. So anyways, GG, Skeleton King, checking out.